The Northwest Museum of Arts and Culture presents Storytime with the Mac, sponsored by STCU. Today's story is The Biggest, Baddest Bear, written and illustrated by E.B. Adams, read with permission from the author. One sunny day, the biggest, baddest bear was walking in the wood. When the bear ran into Rabbit, this was no good.
Rawr! Out of my way! I'm the biggest, baddest bear, okay?
Excuse me, said the rabbit, and stepped out of the way. The bear moved on with a grin and a sway. The biggest, baddest bear was walking in the wood when the bear ran into a squirrel. This was no good.
Roar! Out of my way! I'm the biggest, baddest bear, okay?
Excuse me, said the squirrel, and stepped out of the way. The bear moved on with a grin and a sway. The biggest, baddest bear was walking in the wood when the bear ran into a mole. This was no good.
Blah, blah, blah. Out of my way. I'm the biggest, baddest bear, okay?
Excuse me, said the mole and stepped out of the way. The bear moved on with a grin and a sway. The biggest, baddest bear was walking in the wood when the bear ran into a rock. This was no good.
Argh! Out of my way. I'm the biggest, baddest bear, okay?
The rock did not move, and the bear did not approve.
Ugh! Move, move, move!
The bear had something to prove. I'm the biggest, baddest, plop. The biggest, baddest bear had come to a stop. Now, when animals come to the biggest, baddest rock, they go around it. It's not much of a walk. The end. Excerpt from Bear's Diary.
Dear Diary, my barefoot walk started out lovely, but ended up badly, very badly. First, the good part. The trees were beautiful. Here's a photo I took. Then, the bad part. The walk was spoiled by a rude and mean rabbit barricading my path. But after that, a nice squirrel gave me his lolly. Raspberry flavor. I felt good again. But then, a crazy mole tried to trip me up with his stick. The only good part was this nice pair of sunglasses I found. I look so unbearably cool. But then, the biggest, baddest part. A rock came rolling down the path. I tried to stop it with my bare hands to save the other hikers. I tried my best, but it rolled over me. I was stuck. It was embarrassingly bad. Fortunately, someone called the Silly Wood Park Rangers, and they came and pushed the rock out of the way. And they thanked me for my courage and bravery, and they told me I should never walk here again on account of big bad rocks or something like that.